Speak Student.
Independent and dependent events. A la Shmoop. Congratulations! You've been chosen as a contestant on that game show where people dress up in silly costumes and try to win prizes.
Spin to win!
You're dressed as Euclid, but the host keeps calling you Gandalf. Go figure.
Hi, Mom!
To win the car, you have to spin this spinner and meet two conditions. One, you have to spin an odd number on the first spin. Two, the sum of the two numbers you spin must be odd. We want to know if, using the formal definition of independence,
when the occurrence of one event does not affect the probability of the other.
Events A and B are independent or dependent. Before we start, let's define what makes an event independent or dependent. A dependent event depends on the outcome of a secondary event.
A good example of that is a test score, because factors like studying and lack of sleep can affect your results.
While an independent event doesn't have to answer to anybody, he's more of a free spirit.
Did somebody say free spinach?
An example of an independent event is your age, because no outside factors can affect how old you are.
As the audience cheers you on, let's give this problem a spin. Here's a chart of the possible outcomes. The numbers down the side show up on the first spin. The numbers across the top show up on the second spin. The numbers in the table show the sum of the two spins. Nowhere in there is your new car. Don't get your hopes up.
Let's take a second and look back at those conditions you had to meet. Starting with event A.
You have to spin an odd number on the first spin. Since both 1 and 3 are odd, the probability of getting an odd number on your first spin is good. The probability of A is 2 out of 3.
Now that we've figured out event A, let's move on to event B.
The sum of the two numbers you spin must be odd. It's a little more difficult to spin twice and still have an odd number. Since there are 9 total possible outcomes, and 4 of them are odd, the probability of B on its own is 4 out of 9. But remember, the only results that count are the ones that occur when you spin an odd number first.
Because 2 is an even number, we can't count this 3 or this 5. Therefore,
the probability of A and B happening, the only outcomes that occur in both tables, is 2 out of 9. They don't just make these things easy. Maybe you should just take what's behind curtain number 2. But what we really want to know is whether these events are independent or dependent.
Remember, the only way these two events can be seen as independent is if the probability of A and B is equal to the probability of A times the probability of B.
Since the probability of A, 2/3, times the probability of B, 4/9, which comes out to 8/27, does not equal the probability of A and B, which is 2/9, the events are dependent. We can't give you a car.
Say what?
But we can help give you a better grade.
Ooh.
Which is even better, really. At least with a better grade, you don't have to make monthly payments.
Whoa.